Puan Lee. Welcome to a very special episode of Korea Physical. The guest yang kita ada untuk hari ini is susah nak dapat dia, and then dia selalu main tarik tali macam kejap nak kejap tak nak. So but for this special episode, we managed to get him. This episode is also special sebab aku record, it was recorded entirely on Samsung Galaxy A51 punya phone. Why aku recorded this episode using that phone sebab dia punya long lasting battery life punya feature. Selalu Korea Physical ni panjang, so I need a phone yang boleh can sustain the duration and stuff lah to interview and stuff. Kalau the normal Korea Physical lain, ada cameraman, but when you shoot it at home, I need a good phone. I need a phone yang boleh tahan lama with a long lasting battery life, and of course the video quality yang mencapai piawaian aku lah. Okay, tak payah buang masa lagi, aku nak introduce guest Korea Physical for this week, Adli. Sup bro?
Hey, sup bro? Thanks for having me. Thanks for convincing me. Terang kau kau boleh convince aku untuk buat this Korea Physical. Aku malu orangnya sebenarnya.
Macam biasa, aku akan biar Adli korek all the physical releases yang ada dekat rumah dia, and then we tengoklah apa cerita dia sebelum order releases. You ready bro?
Let's do this.
So bro, kau ingat tak the first album yang kau beli?
Yang aku betul-betul paling ingat dia adalah compilation masa tu Grammys nominees tahun 84 pun.
What about kau punya music exposure? Siapa yang play a major role in like apa introducing you to music?
I would say bapa aku, sebab aku remember dia ada collection of LP yang aku ingat betul-betul yang dalam collection dia was Grand Funk Railroad, sebab cover dia gambar orang batu depan gua. My dad was music, well dia cikgu music, and then dia masa muda-muda dulu dia main band kat in the 60s, and then uncle pakcik-pakcik belah bapa aku pun play a major role, sebab aku dari kecil aku memang membesar dengan orang surrounded by older people, so kawan-kawan yang sebaya tu tak ramai sangat, so aku ada kawan-kawan yang dah masa tu dia orang dah in their teens and stuff. Then daripada pakcik-pakcik aku juga, dia bekalkan aku balik dengan dia bagi aku cassette Death Leopard Pyromania, ACDC Jailbreak 74, and then Dio Holy Diver. I think that was the exposure aku. And then aku punya neighbor aku masa tu dia kat sekolah menengah, aku darjah 1 darjah 2 punya tu, so dia orang banyak expose aku dekat muzik macam masa tu Loudness, Quiet Riot, Twisted Sister, glam rock ah, and then Battle of the Bands. Oh, masa tu semua jadi rock ah, semua memang aku didedahkan dari kecil dengan benda-benda rock, benda-benda yang shocking lah, dia shocking meaning like kalau orang pakcik-pakcik atau angka-angka tengok, eh asal dia ni dengar benda-benda macam ni kan, asal dia ni macam masa tu budaya kuning baru nak start kot, baru orang nak baru nak dipopularisekan oleh the government or orang-orang yang people in authority.
Okay, bila sebut nama Adli je, orang selalu cakap, okay, kau, your association with local music ni, dia macam, aku tak nak lah puji kau kan, tapi reputable lah, you know. So how did you know, the interest toward local music develop?
I think it started off dengan death metal music, masa tu Grand Crusher punya compilation. Daripada situ, I was exposed to extreme metal music. So, lepas dengar Grand Crusher tu, aku macam, I fell in love dengan Morbid Angel, Godflesh, itu kan Napalm Death, Carcass. So music preference aku memang was leaning towards extreme metal lah. So masa tu ada fanzine, aku ingat ada fanzine daripada France, Are You a Man or Are You a Mouse. Lepas tu ada lagi satu fanzine, aku tak ingat apa nama fanzine tu, tapi dalam tu dia ada feature satu band, band ni Nocturnal dari Singapore. So cakap, Singapore pun ada band metal ya. So from there, dari kawan-kawan semua, I discovered macam band-band metal, extreme metal dari Malaysia. I think one of the earliest one was, yang aku dengar nama was Traitor. And then lepas tu, keluar FTG yang ada lagu Behind This Wall. Lagu Behind This Wall masuk music dua time tu, gila b**k. Aku ingat rambut one of the band member sebelah eh. FTG, and then Komok from my uncle. So aku discover band Kelantan ni, masa tu Suffocation, tapi ada band US nama Suffocation, so they change their name to Suffocation. Aku ingat dia punya album masa keluar tu, gambar hantu bawa macam usung mayat, bawa keranda. So that was tu, and then Silhanas. Yeah, Silhanas. So yeah, from extreme metal, they slowly discover banyak lagi. And then aku discover banyak some of the local fanzine. Antara yang terawal aku discover was Adis Jokitnya. So, okay, speaking of punk, macam mana daripada extreme music tu kau boleh berganjak ke punk? And then, what do you see in punk?
Macam aku cakap tadi, it started off dengan extreme metal music. And then, somehow, the trend shifted into punk. I think lepas Nirvana punya, Nevermind punya explosion masa tu, Nevermind album tu dia, yelah bila kau baca magazine masa dulu, dulu tak ada internet eh, ada magazine je, Enemy or Kerrang. Dia banyak sebut punk. Bila Nirvana je ada word punk, so dia ada association tu. So daripada association, daripada word punk tu, I think dia trigger tu, like macam selain apa lagi band macam Nirvana. So bila kita okay, apa lagi band yang macam inspired Nirvana tu sound like Nirvana. So the word punk was almost everywhere. So daripada situ start to read, discover more about what punk is. Then barulah kita backtrack and then discover the 70s punya punk, the 80s punya hardcore punk, and then like the progress macam tu lah. But I think one of the key essence of apart from music hook me up to punk was I think the fact that macam the attitude yang macam okay, there's no such thing as tak boleh, ada je jalan, there's always a way, provided kau kena pandai cari jalan lah, kau kena, you need to be resourceful lah. So yeah, that was one of the things about punk yang buat macam ui, aku suka benda ni tu, sebab the always can do punya attitude. And then always the attitude yang macam kau challenge je. Lagi orang cakap tak boleh, lagi kau buat. Either for to prove them wrong ataupun for sekadar shock factor. So benda-benda tu lah. So from there memang aku sangkut teruk kat punk. So I still appreciate extreme metal music, tapi in terms of the philosophy tu memang punk. Sial lah, ini Korek Fizikal ke Korek Adli ni? So yeah, ni dah panjang sangat. If you want a full episode of Korek Fizikal dengan aku, what you have to do is to ensure that for the Samsung punya campaign, aku, Syafa, E dengan Akid, kita orang berentak. And aku tak start korek lagi pun. If you want more, please make sure aku win in this Samsung Galaxy S20 punya challenge. Meaning menang dengan meninggalkan Syafa, E dengan Akid bertapak-tapak, berkilu-kilu, bertiang-tiang. So yeah, kalau if you want more, make sure aku datang.